everyone, this is Kaushika Patel from the Department of Pharmaceutical Technology, LJ Institute of Pharmacy. Welcome to MOOC series, an initiative started by LJ University. In this session, we are going to discuss about powder dosage forms. We all are aware that there are two types of dosage forms, liquid and solid dosage forms, which are used in the market. Out of all the solid dosage forms, except tablet and capsule, all the other category of solid dosage forms falls in the powder dosage form. So let's understand what are the different powder dosage forms. So first of all, how you can define a powder dosage form? So it is a dosage form in which there is medicament, either there is a single medicament or more than one medicament with or without excipients in it. It can be available in different type of forms like crystalline or amorphous form depending upon its use and applicability. So, if you classify the powders, then basically the classification is based upon whether you want to use that powder internally, that means you have to take it orally, or you have to apply externally either on the skin or on any of the body cavities. Okay, so first class is powders to be used for internal use. So as you can see, internal use powders, they are of two types. Either they can be divided powder or they can be bulk powder. Divided powders, they are directly supplied in a unit dosage form. That means one dose you have to take each time during administration. So such many doses will be given, so they are divided powders. Second will be bulk powder, which are supplied in a container in bulk form, and you have to measure the dose yourself for taking that formulation. Okay? Divided powders, they can be of four different types. Either they can be simple powder or compound powder based upon its composition. They can be powder enclosed in capsule or cachet. Or they can be tablet triturates, which are molded into a small tablet by using a specific mold. Then there can be bulk powder for external use. Whenever you have external use powders, they are always supplied in bulk. They are never supplied in divided form. So you can see that bulk powders for external use, they are of four types. They can be either dusting powder, they can be insufflation, snuff or dentrifies. Then the third category is based upon the different or some specific dispensing technique which is required for such powders. So they are known as special powders, which will not be supplied or dispensed in a conventional manner, but you have to take some additional care in their dispensing. Okay, so there are many such special types of powders like effervescent powder, potent powder, hygroscopic or deliquescent powder, eutectic powder, powders for reconstitution or explosive powder. Okay, then what are the advantages? Different advantages of the powder dosage forms over other solid dosage forms or liquid dosage forms. Okay, so first advantage, as we have seen, the powders can be used internally as well as externally. Then they are more stable than liquid dosage form, because since there is no solvent or liquid, the chances of microbial growth and contamination is less, and the other parameters affecting stability are also less. Then there will be a relaxation of dose. You can prescribe a dose specific to a patient, and that can be taken from the bulk or can be supplied in the divided form. It is easy to carry and transport, and its overall transportation and packaging cost is also lower compared to the liquid dosage form due to its reduced size. Then it has faster onset of action, okay, because it is directly available in a small particle size in a fine powder form, so its solubility is more, and then it can dissolve faster compared to other solid dosage forms, and that's why its onset of action is faster compared to tablet and capsules. And it is easy to administer, okay, because powder can be dissolved in any suitable solvent, water, juice, anything you require, and you can provide it to the patient. And then you can even mask its taste by giving it with some honey or any other flavored liquid. So its administration is easy and taste masking is also possible. Now, along with the advantages, there will always be some disadvantages. So, what are the limitations? There are certain types of powders which are not stable, which are affected by the environmental conditions like moisture and humidity, and so their dispensing becomes difficult and their stability is also less. So, such powders, they cannot be preferred or dispensed in powder dosage forms. Okay? Then there are certain bitter tasting drugs. Now, if you are giving a drug in powder form, its tasting capacity is very high. So, such bitter drugs, they will cause nausea and vomiting to the patient. So, they are not dispensed in powder dosage forms. Okay? Then, there are certain drugs which are potent and which have to be given in a very low quantity. Then, such drugs, they are also preferably not provided in the powder dosage forms. Okay? Now, mixing of powder. Okay, now when we are dispensing the powder, the most important step is mixing of different ingredients of the powder dosage form. Okay, so the main purpose of mixing is to get a homogeneous mixture where all the ingredients, they are equally distributed and are and in proper contact with each other. So there are parameters like particle size, shape, surface charge that affect the mixing of the powder. So what are the different methods by which you can mix the powders? First is mechanical mixing, where you can use mechanical equipments, mixtures, they will help to mix the powder uniformly. But that will be possible in bulk quantity in large scale. Then there is hand mixing. If you are preparing powder on small scale, then you cannot use mechanical mixtures. So you will have to go for hand mixing techniques like spatulation, where spatula will be used, or trituration where motor pestle will be used, or tumblers where only the tumbling of the mixing of the ingredients will take place. Third is the geometric dilution method. What is geometric dilution method? This method is preferred when you have to mix unequal quantity of solid ingredients. Okay, so if you have one ingredient in very small quantity and other ingredient in very large quantity, then such uneven proportions can be mixed properly by using geometric dilution method. In this method, you will require one diluent which is inert in nature, that is mixed stepwise with the medicament in such a way that in each step the original quantity is doubled. That's why it is also known as doubling method. Okay, so how you have to execute this method? So in first step, you have to take the quantity of drug which is required. You have to mix it with the same amount of diluent, mostly lactose is preferred. Then you have to mix them. So you get 40 milligram triturate in first step. In second step, you have to double the quantity. So it will become 80 milligram. Then in third step, it will become 160 milligram. Like this, in each step, you have to keep on doubling the quantity till you get the final dispensed quantity. Okay? Then, what are the general steps which you have to use in dispensing any type of powder? Okay? So, first type is bulk powder. If you are preparing a bulk powder, the first step will be size reduction. So, you have to reduce the particle size. You have to make uniform particle size of all the ingredients which you have to use by a proper method that can be levigation, trituration or pulverization. Then, after size reduction, you have to mix all the ingredients by a suitable mixing technique that can be spatulation, trituration. You can shift them together or you can mix them in a tumbler. And third step will be packaging and labeling. If you are dispensing divided powders, then the first two steps remain same. You have to size reduce the powder, you have to mix the powder. But then in third step, you have to divide the entire mixture into single individual doses of powder. So that dividing can be done by either estimation. If you have expertise, then you can divide the entire quantity into equal number of dosage forms. You can weigh each and every individual powder by using a weighing scale, or you can use a measure like spoon or spatula with which you can divide the powder. Or there is one technique known as dividing and blocking, where you have to form a block on a tile and then you have to divide it into equal number of blocks, and each and every that small block will form a single dosage form. And finally, you have to package and label that formulation. Okay? Now, packaging. For powder dosage form, what type of packaging materials are preferred? So, normally if you have a simple or compound powder in small quantity, we wrap the powder in a powder packets. That packets can be made from butter paper, from simple white paper, from aluminium foil or any type of special type of paper you can use. For simple powder which are not sensitive to environmental condition, you can use single wrapping. For powders which are sensitive to moisture or humidity, you can use double wrapping, where the second wrapper will provide impermeation to the surrounding condition. Then, if you are having external powders, the bulk powders which is to be used externally, then you can use the packaging material like shifter top containers, where there are pores through which you can sprinkle, like talcum powder, which are available in the market. You can use pressurized containers for certain insufflations. You can use flat metal boxes for snuffs. You can use wide mouthed jar for simple powder, which is to be used externally. And you can even use plastic containers with flip top lid as shown in the image. Then if you have bulk powders which is to be used internally, then you can use a wide mouthed powder jar. You can use simple transparent powder jar for a simple powder which is stable. And amber color jars you can use for light sensitive powders. And then you can supply some measuring device like spoon or spatula with the packaging as a tertiary packaging material with which the powder can be weighed to take the dose uniformly. Labeling. Okay. Whenever you are preparing any formulation, you have to write the general labeling requirements like its name, its quantity, its supplier, manufacturing date, expiry date, etc. You have to write. But along with that, there are certain important stability concerning directions which you have to include on the label, which are known as auxiliary labeling requirements. So, what conditions you have to mention in the label? First is the storage condition. So, mostly all the powders, they have to be stored in cool and dry place, okay. If you are having some light sensitive drug, then you have to keep it away from light, or you have to store it in dark place also. Then if you are having a powder to be used externally, then you have to mention for external use only. For internal formulations, nothing is mentioned, that means it can be taken orally. For external formulation, it is compulsory to write for external use only. Then keep out of reach of children or any other special requirement concerning to that formulation, you have to mention on the label. Okay, so these are all the general requirements for dispensing the powder. In the next lecture, we will continue with the special dispensing requirements for the individual powder. I hope you have liked the session. For more updates, subscribe our YouTube channel Pharma Ignite. Press the bell icon for the notifications. Thank you and see you soon.